We're not on stream yet, are we?
Not yet.
We are about right now putting up the tweet.
Okie dokie.
Means I should get the Twitch open.
Stop doom scrolling, play Jackbox. Oh man. I just learned about that term recently too, yesterday. And I'm like, where did that come from? Then I had to read up about it.
Oh, let's do this one.
Quip retreat, huh? Oh, okay.
Oh, we've already got 12 people in here.
Oh, wait, I'm not... Oh, you mean...
He means in the stream?
Yeah.
Yes, and then... Yeah, no, not in this Discord. That would raise questions. I would have questions if we had 12 people in this Discord.
And Miller is the VIP.
Wait. Oh... I haven't actually got the stream open, or the screen. Oh, right, Jackbox. Ugh, criminy. A few nights of Stardew and I completely forget everything. Alright. Oh, good. My little coffiny face is still available! Clip retreat!
Okay. Miller, you need to click everybody's
We got Jewish! And we got Drakon, and we got Federic. Whoosh.
Caitlin Goss' cat sleeps on the PlayStation 4? Nice.
This is a game we call Quiplash 3. No refunds. I'm Schmitty,
no? And I cannot... What do I want refunds? Quipping.
You with me? And extra players can put in that room...
Quip it good. Audience. This is alright.
Two prompts will show up on your device. Answer them however the mood strikes. You'll go head-to-head against someone else's clever answer, and everybody else will decide which one they like better. Points are awarded based on the percentage of people who went for your answer, so make them count.
Alright, what have we got?
Seconds.
Don't let me down.
We won't.
I might.
Sizer is so obsolete. Today the Grim Reaper carries a lightsaber, purple lightsaber, or Twitter app, it makes you give up on life.
So, in one of these cases, the Grim Reaper is Samuel L. Jackson.
specifically on the Grim Reaper's Twitter app. It's just, he just comes up to you and he says, "This blue check mark said you're wrong."
All right, what's the audience going for? Just barely edged it out.
Ugh.
Yours was a good answer though, GC.
Form Pennywise would take to terrorize you. Man-sized red rocket or a missed credit card payment.
Oh.
Huh.
Me terrified, but also turned on at the idea of credit card debt.
Sounds a little more like a Transformer would do, though.
Spookiest inscription you could find on a tombstone. This is your grave in 3, 2, 1, or I dead now.
Player made props, nice.
Well done, Fed.
Without further ado, good sign the ghost in your house is haunting the wrong address. They plan for Michael Myers or anime themed funeral.
I mean, obviously, it would have to be a furry themed funeral, so.
I had nothing for this one.
And yet...
I was tempted to go for that.
Quickest way to summon Jewish is to look in a mirror and say, "What does your name really mean?" Or Gesundheit.
No, not Gesundheit. Gesunderheit.
Gesunderheit.
Oh, hey, Rootsworks. We're just having a silly game night here.
And maybe I should pronounce
somebody
that
in the South would call it just under hit.
Just under hit. Well done, GC.
Nom, 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 nom. Thank you.
Good sign that someone is pure evil.
Well, someone was off on their prediction.
I would have gone the absolute.
Say, no more doom scrolling.
I would have gone the absolute minimum on that and says, tells everybody they're chocolate chip cookies, but they're raisin.
Oh, a tie, even though my answer was completely wrong.
Weirdest and least used of Dracula's powers. Scalp leaks, hair gel, or Stoker.
Okay, you know what? You know what? I can forgive this for not going to me.
Although, Dracula's scalp-leaking hair gel is probably one of his most used powers.
Definitely the weirdest one.
It's just the one that goes unremarked upon the most.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you just have to read the cut chapters of the book. You have to read Bram Stoker's notes.
One up. A fly was bad enough, but it would be worse if your teleporter combined you with your old fursona or anything that wouldn't make you your fursona.
No.
I've never had a different fursona from my current one.
So. I still like all my old fursonas, so.
I still have, like, half a persona, I guess, now that Jonas has drawn this image. I have something, I guess.
PCY. Bum. Round one is behind us, and the. I know. I'm not ashamed to try. I played Jordan. That was my old persona.
All right. I don't think I did super great that round. So let's see where I am. Fourth? Could be worse.
Round two is upon us. Put on your best quip face. I fired too early for the dirty answers. I need to wait until we get a little more loopy.
Well, I'm drinking already, so.
You're drinking already.
Ooh, I like this one. This is going to be a story. This might end up becoming a story time because of this answer. Oh, you got a good one there, Rick?
Yes. I don't know if my answer was any good, but that was a good prompt.
Alright.
Time's almost up. Hurry!
10 seconds.
Alright, whatever.
It's quip time. And the first prompt is...
Here's where this house is haunted. All it's built on top of Michael Myers' grave or Tough Stains.
I mean, Michael Myers has technically never died, but... Oh, geez, Rick, you're hitting the tequila?
Yeah.
I mean, you know what? That's fair.
I've hydrated enough. I won't have a hangover, hopefully. Tough Stains is a really good answer to that, though.
And also, like I said, technically Michael Myers has never died.
Mellow Dark didn't have candy. They'd hand out blank on Halloween. Sodas or fried goat? I don't know. I don't know them that well. LOL. What do you think, Miller?
So here's the thing. We did that at my house. We didn't hand out candy. We handed out sodas.
Let's see how they handle.
The only good thing about having an alien stuck in your face, hey, this is my kink though, or breakfast the next morning.
Oh, these are both really good answers.
Nice one, Frederick.
And next is...
One thing you should not do when trick-or-treating at the White House. Rick tonight's election, probably, or Obama called, said you were giving out king size.
Well, you can't avoid the political jokes on this one, now, can you?
Nope.
I was going to say something about trying to climb the cardboard fence.
Cardboard fence.
Yeah, they put a cardboard fence around the White House tonight, and they spray painted it to look like concrete.
I knew about the fence, I didn't know it was cardboard.
The best Halloween costume you can make for $5. Game Cobra with a hockey mask and fake machete, or toilet paper mummy.
That's such a good political metaphor. They took a cardboard fence and spray painted it to look like concrete. It's such reality is written by a hack.
It was me.
It was me. It was you underneath the mask all along.
Oh, God.
I really liked your answer, though.
One word that is made a lot scarier if you add of blood after it. Parent Teacher Association of Blood! Or baby of blood!
I love how, in this case, one word means three. I had a really difficult time with this one. Oh! Well, okay then. Still work in my favor.
Why does Slender Man wear a business suit? Forever wanders the earth searching a job, or jobs pay more.
Slender Man is just the eternally unemployed contract worker.
I once heard him referred to as, like, someone who was talking about him was, like, you know, trying to remember what he was called, and they were like, what's that? Who's that fancy maitre d' everyone's scared of?
Next we have... Werewolves would be a lot less frightening if they transformed into squirrels or ooh ooh bappy pubs. All right, people,
I mean, again, the audience.
Oh, whoa, what's this? Full moon?
Where squirrels could still be scary.
I mean, yeah. Squirrels took down Galactus once.
Where's Dith? So we need their take on this?
Didn't they take down Dr. Doom?
Oh, probably. I mean, Squirrel Girl is unbeatable.
Round two is through. Let's see how things shook out.
Spider-Verse is still up there in the lead.
But not by, well, okay, actually 1,000 points. It's a pretty good lead.
You can't underestimate rhetoric. Separate responses. You'll do great.
All right, what's our category?
Tick-tock, time's almost up.
Seven. Five.
Oh, no.
Okay, it's all right, what we got?
Okay, I submitted just on time.
3 steps to surviving the Overlook Hotel. Bring a pocket knife, call Ghostbusters beforehand, bring your own blood slash insanity, or... hide all sharp objects, don't talk to strangers, leave the production set.
Yes, the real terror is Stanley Kubrick.
I was gonna say, all you need to do is say, get Kubrick off set, get Michael Bay off set, be a white guy with stubble.
Dee 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 dee
percent do you need to get a Quiplash?
Three things that terrifies Frankenstein more than fire. Pink, Elmira, and the brain, or that his creator is a loser, that there are no others like, that he was made by a woman.
I believe that should have been pink E, but I still think it's a good answer.
Hey.
Roots Work says Stanley Kubrick has tricked everyone into believing the moon is real, so.
And you're right, that was supposed to be pinky.
Well done, GC.
I think in order to get a Quiplash, you need three steps of making candy corn. Candy, corn, trash can, or real corn flavoring, fine confectioner sugar, throw that out and use paste.
These are both really good.
Oh yeah, I've heard that before, that Kubrick faked the landing, but he wanted it to be so precise that he made them do it for real.
Yeah, I think in order to get Quiplash, everybody who's in the game has to vote for you, and it has to be like 90% of the audience or something.
Okay.
Yeah.
Three safety precautions this summer camp is instituting after all those grisly murders. One, hire only horny teens. Two, leave them unsupervised. Three, wait, they're dead again. All right, no weird haunted kids, no hockey mask wearing, no killing or timeout rule.
I am shocked you didn't vote for me on that one, GC. Now let's see those final scores. I believe I may have stolen this one. Right at the last minute.
Congratulations, you're now the perfect little bean.
Top answer of the game, anything that you wouldn't make into your fursona, that's Rick. Or wouldn't make you your fursona.
Okay, let's see.
Oh shoot, I wanted to save some of those. Oh well.
Alright, Snake Hugs, now's your chance. You just gotta be fast.
Alright, yeah, the password is Slovak.
That's what I thought too, so.
Slovak.
Lego Suffers, Frederick, Snake Hugs, and Boxer.
Yeah, okay, everybody down.
Good night, Bear.
Hey, welcome to Quiplash 3. Rotten to the core. I'm Schmitty, here to facilitate all your quipping needs. Round 1. Oh yes, points. You score points based on the percentage of voters who like your answers. Clear enough? Sure hope so. Let's go.
Thank you.
15 seconds.
You're almost out of time. Don't forget your safety quips.
Melodarkid, it is down to you, and you have 2 seconds.
Okay, I got it just in time. Sorry. I had a joke. No, I had to quickly type it out.
What does Frankenstein actually want? Bring his fursona to life or an actual doctor?
Okay, show some love. Oh, hey, Ty.
What would a fursona be?
I mean, Frankenstein's monster is green, so some kind of lizard, probably?
That should be Godzilla.
Godzilla. I could see that. It's easy to forget that he was not, in fact, a doctor.
I'm not good at these.
Pure Life was an M. Night Shyamalan movie. What's the shocking twist ending? Video games are really torture stories in box, or I was in an M. Night Truman Show all along.
Ah, but Diego, that was the point. He is in fact not a doctor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in the book he never actually graduated, so.
It's true.
Oof. Medric. Oh. Nice one though. Next is
even better treat than full-size candy bars. Chocolate bar as big as a toddler, or sexy cat costume that turns you into sexy cat.
I wonder who wrote the one on the right.
Gee, I wonder who's going to vote for the, how people are going to vote for these.
I mean, they should have just said, the one on the left should have just been, like, the Toblerone from the... what was his name? Northwest anime? What was Kanye West's son's name?
To be fair, nice. I would love a really big apple bar, but not that big.
What do they do with the extra pumpkins on November 1st? Process them into candy corn vats for next year, or carve a special hole into them?
Oh, cursed. Cursed answers. Yeah. Still edged out of victory.
Best way to tell if the invisible man is crashing your party. Keep feeling a stiff wind or throw glitter everywhere.
Like 5 more seconds, I would put quotation marks around stiff wind.
All right, check this out. Scariest movie ever created, Night of the Endless Election or Furries? It's voting time. Yeah, I knew election was too obvious, but...
And yet.
Sorry, Rick. I'm there. Without further ado...
Something a ghost could say other than boo. Boo shakalikya. Or do you have a sec to talk about our lord and...
It's a Jehovah's Witness.
I like to talk to you about the great deals we have up here in heaven. Reserve your package now.
Oh. My initial instinct was to go for like an insurance commercial pitch. Hmm. But I think I made the right choice.
Ow! I'm dead.
Sorry, GC.
It happens.
Creepiest thing to see on your home security footage while you slept, McConnell silently looking over me as I sleep, or Five Nights at Freddy's. Choose your favorite.
I mean, it doesn't even matter if you're talking about the senator, any McConnell watching over you when you sleep, if you don't have a McConnell in your house.
Yeah, you need to make sure your security system has the fine text in it that it will be McConnell-free.
Yeah, that'd be an interesting idea for a ghost story. Someone is absolutely convinced that they have a ghost in their house, but it turns out that it's just their security system that's haunted.
Right?
I took a locket of round one's hair to remember it by. Let's look at the scores.
Lego is ahead of me. Lego is the one I must destroy.
The points are doubled, but so are the expectations.
There's a new one. I shouldn't be surprised. There's a new FNAF that will never end.
Yeah. The new FNAF looks kind of interesting because it's like a lot glittery and like very nice looking. It's like a high-end casino. It's no longer like a Chuck E. Cheese.
Man. Time's almost done. Save your bacon with a safety quip. Okay, here's where the fun starts. Starting off...
Everybody avoids the house at the top of the hill. They say it's full of anti-vaxxers or furries are having a perpetual fur con.
Yeah, I knew that was gonna win.
Seems like the group you want to stay away from.
Okay, what's next?
Quite literally for your health.
Rejected catchphrase for Freddy Krueger: snooze or bitch, 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 bitch.
Alright, that's good.
I'm picturing it in my headcanon voice for Ali from A&H Club 2.
Quit!
And what makes me unhappy, I used to think of these catchers all the time when I was a kid.
Worst thing you see to see sitting at the foot of your bed, a facehugger or Fivey Fox licking your toes.
Who's Fivey Fox? Oh. They're talking about, okay.
The 8-year-old kid and he's beating me up now.
I have officially allowed the phrase bitch, 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 bitch.
Worse threat than trick or treat, blank or treat, extended partisan political debate, or evisceration.
Well, we all know which of the two of these is worse.
See, if you wanted to go with the violent angle, I would have liked to see Brick or Treat.
Brick or Treat.
So, what exactly caused this zombie apocalypse? Novel coronavirus 2021 or the cat flu?
Oh, current events.
Again, another one that I was thinking of a lot of times when I was growing up.
Previous theme for a haunted house is This is Horny DMS or that one Garfield Halloween special strip.
I think it's DMs.
Okay, DMs. This is Horny DMs.
The ones he receives or the ones he sends? That's the question.
Am I thinking of the Garfield strip where there's like a pirate in it?
Well, it's the one where Garfield wakes up alone in his house. And it's all run down and everything.
Okay.
The one with the pirate is the Halloween special that was made into a cartoon. Creepiest message a ghost could write in a fog mirror, a RP request, or go back to the old shower curtain I can't see.
Man!
Oh no! I was defeaterated!
We should know our eyes by now, Stoker.
Be careful of things that go blank in the night. Whatever Stoker does at night, or fart. Now it's time to
vote for your favorite. I mean, listen. It's not hard to guess what I do in the night.
You sleep upside down?
Yes. I'm still counting that as a victory for me.
I have underestimated Rick.
For round two, time really flies, huh? Let's see your scores.
Yeah.
Oh, you're still way ahead of me, Lego.
At least I'm in the top half now. That's all I want. And all rounds. I'm going to send each of you a prompt that requires three
separate responses. Don't screw it up, okay? I make no promises, announcer man. All right, what did you give me? Okay, fine.
Time's almost up, hurry!
Five seconds. One second.
One!
I'm ready if you are.
Three costumes it would be hard to make a sexy version of: Lavos, Thanatos, Xanatos, or Fred Durst from Limp Bizkit. Donald Trump, ULL.
Damn.
Did Dis write the second one?
Dang, I thought it was good.
Three trick-or-treat offerings that might as well be straight-up garbage. Those orange wrap PV things, toothbrush, Chick Track, actual garbage, old magazines, raisins.
Okay, everybody, pick your favorite quip.
Well, some of these I have actually gotten, so...
Of these six options, there is one that absolutely makes me angry.
Man, what are those orange wrapped PB things?
I don't know.
I've never even known the name of them.
I've never even seen them for sale anywhere. Three steps to a foolproof witch test. See if they float in water, see if they float in magma, see if they are still. Okay. Cinnamon challenge, ALS ice bucket challenge, iron stomach challenge.
You know what? If someone floats in magma, not only are they a witch, but I'm not messing with them.
A lot of things float in magma, though. Magma is very dense.
Well, okay, but if they float in magma with no ill effects.
Okay. Okay. I was trying to go for, like, a 21st century witch test.
Only three acceptable dog costumes: cute devil, cute wish, cute multi-legged abomination, or wiener mailman stoker with rabies.
That's real. Pick your favorite.
So, dog, bat, rabies? Hey, I love this tune, hey!
Oh, dang! Well, Lego, you have won this game. There's no way I can catch you now.
I cannot live with this tension. Show me the final scores!
Well, I missed the old
one. You used my name, so I'm still declaring victory.
Hey, I got bumped into third place with that.
Yeah!
Oh, he looks so happy! I can't even be upset.
It's a lucky charm. Endless election, yeah. That was a steamroller answer there. Okay. What shall we do next?
Alright, y'all, don't even get me started on the history of vampire media. I can and will talk about it endlessly.
Champed up.
You want to do champed up?
Yep. I'm game.
Okay, let me open this up on...
I'm gonna try without my pad this time. I think I did better on this without the pad.
Okay, jump back here, close that.
All right, let's see what the code is. There it is.
There's my girl. There she is.
Alright, who am I gonna be? I'm gonna be the weird eye flower again. I like that one. Yeah, OMLM. On my level, man.
Oh, I just gotta pronounce it OMLM.
OMLM. Alright, we got Federic, we got Gira the Ott, we got Lone Wolf, and we got Boxer. And we got Death Star.
Conan.
Sam Coon's not in this time, yeah. So. He can't sweep this thing.
Welcome to the
Scrolliseum. These talented trainers are about to face off to see who's the best at creating champion characters with unusual skills. Will the underdogs take down the heavy favorites? It's time to get champed up.
All right, let's see what we got.
Oh, screen's still back. Okay, let me...
Hold on, there I gotta go. Remember to get my... Okay. Draw and name a particular type of capacitive pen. Character.
They'll be equipped with two tools, a pen for drawing and a thick marker for coloring in. Once a character is drawn and named, it can be submitted...
Why do you humiliate me, game? Been set.
Off we go.
All right, what have we got? Champ! Oh my god, are you serious? Oh my god. Oh god. Okay. I will not be able to do this justice, but I will try. No.
You know what I like about the drawing program on this one?
What's that?
The undo button is not near the submit button.
Yeah, that's nice.
That would be a huge quality, yes.
This is incredible, but
20 seconds remain. Players need to name their character.
Okay.
Hey, let's see. Oh, I don't think Federic got in time.
These characters will be the underdogs because their creators will see who they're competing against, but not what the contest will be. So they must analyze their opponent's unique skill set to create what they hope is a worthy challenger. Let's see the drama unfold.
Okay, let's see. Okay. Thank you. Wait, why is it saying that I'm still... Oh, I didn't hit submit. I hope I hit submit last time.
I think it does it for you automatically.
It's time to name those characters!
It doesn't... I think this game really doesn't like people not finishing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's time for the main event. Here comes our first brave warrior.
Kakko
Demon Fury.
Demon Ramsay.
Demon.
Battle to see who is champion of flavor.
Oh. I mean,
not
yeah,
you.
Kinda.
And the audience, you both are all filthy and bad at cooking.
I mean, if it had been Flavor Town, this would have been less one-sided.
It's a cat out of the heat! Get out of hell!
Super cool, fantastic. Cat on a high shelf!
Gee, who drew that?
Sergeant Super Soaker.
We're watching a scribble quibble. It's a close one. The tides are turning.
Sometimes we Rick did that cat on the high shelf. What? I got it right?
No.
The 42%
of the audience stands you.
Debt forever, boy. And opposing them will be just an American college grad.
Oh no.
The champion of trust fund kids.
Neither?
The exact opposite.
Now this is a duel. Talk about a character assassination.
That is such a sad face.
Yet somehow he can slice that guy up.
No question, this trainer is a fan favorite.
They bask in your glory.
Next up, it'll be
Little Baby post gratification. Little Baby.
Facing off to see who is the champion of the kids' table.
Well, if you're actually making them fight it out.
I think it's trying to be... They walked over to the kids' table, which one would get more pets?
Sign my baby.
Moving on,
the band hammer. Unfortunate 80 chips man.
Them will walk out as the champion of savory.
Not sure what the banhammer has to do with savory. Or what it has to do with unfortunate 80 chips man.
I read that as unfortunate ad chips man, so oh wait, I guess I just gave away who the banhammer was drawn by. Oh lord.
Absolutely.
Make way for
Jimmy Spaghetti of the Yeti
versus
Finny Finmore.
Only one can be the champion of shyness.
Man, I wonder which one.
Who's the champion of shyness? If any of you know anything about one of these two characters.
Is it the one in the straitjacket or the one who turns red as a tomato every other page?
Yeah, look at my glorious art. Aren't you sorry I'm not drawing this comic?
The cat's pajamas. Or rather, lack of pajamas.
Yeah, well, she lacks pajamas.
It's her splitter. Versus the big knife.
These two are competing to be the champion of the midlife crisis. What a battle!
Was that like the knife after using it on the wife?
It's the clash of the titans. Oh, I see what you did there.
That's
sick.
He stabbed me.
Up next, Stoker. Game Cobra.
Looks exactly like me. Oh my gosh, what is this? Okay, listen. My drama days are long in the past, okay?
Hi, Stoker.
Literally nobody's worrying. Yeah, I knew who drew that.
Thanks, Fred.
I just smacked you with my face, GC.
And that takes us to halftime. Here are the scores.
Well, I'm in sixth.
Well, now we know what Grape looks like when she's painted green.
I shall forever take a picture of that one. That was good. Oh, yeah, sorry. Posty.
Why is there no gray?
Because they want to force you to be colorful.
I guess.
What the heck?
Uh-oh.
Okay, let me see if I can convey what I'm thinking.
Am I the only one who hears Bad Romance?
I could kind of hear it.
Now that you mention it, sort of. It's getting there.
Submit, right? Yes, I did. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, shoot.
Submit!
I thought I did. Ooh, I got it in time.
It's the second half, which means it's time for the tag teams. Each matchup will include a surprise contest where players can tag out their characters. The bonus points are doubled, and votes for both contests will be cumulative. Let's start things off with our first two fighters.
Thing 1 and Thing 2, 2003 movie versions, and Craig and Drag.
Champion of Big Energy.
Oh, that would totally be.
Never even saw the original of the 2003 movie.
Here we go. It's not over yet. Here's the next title up for grabs. The champion of community theater.
And
will the trainers keep their characters or swap out?
I mean, to be fair, I gotta change my vote.
Oh.
Ooh.
Should have kept it, Craig and Drag.
Really? Okay.
Community theater. They were just in, like, the Imaginate arc.
I know, I was thinking about that, but I'm just like, eh.
100%
how many people know house pet stuff? And I don't know why I thought
like,
that.
Like, at least 90% of the people in the audience. So, Mascot Kimura, or the pink elephant from Dumbo.
I like how one of these Chimera heads looks just kind of like a happy potato. It's a very happy potato, but still.
We'll declare a winner after this next match. The champion of haunting your dreams tonight.
That's too easy.
I gotta vote for me. Sorry, y'all.
Yeah.
Nope, I still win. I'm gaining so many votes. Oh my god.
I would have laughed if they switched me up to fight Stalker for that title.
Tailypo. I got my Tailypo.
Lice Water, probably also Stoker.
Sketchy
carnival. I really like my look as a carnival barker, though. I kind of want to see this as a finished pick.
Stoker the Ringmaster.
This next contest could swing things. The champion of child entertainers. Will the players tag out?
Yeah, I couldn't see Stoker doing that.
Are you kidding? I'm great as a child entertainer.
Yeah.
Well, now I'm confused. Is child entertainers that you're an entertainer as a child, or that you entertain children?
Entertain children.
Okay. I don't know why.
To be fair, I did.
This is a side.
I did have a major stage role in my fourth grade production of Peter Pan at school.
Cal Eating Ghost versus T Steam 1000.
Three guesses who I played in our Peter Pan production.
Tinkerbell.
Yeah, wow, nailed it in one. No, I was Hook!
It all comes down to this next match. The champion of not getting invited to the wedding.
Well, I mean, they do give you so many towels as wedding gifts.
Bam, right in the face.
Ooh. Ooh.
Whoever has the T-Steam 1000 may consider tagging out. Too late.
Too late.
I'm surprised that even happened.
Like a toaster for my wedding, I wouldn't exclude it. Here are the next
two players. Mind control, sense manipulating nose, tinfoil hat man.
Who is the champion of smelling fantastic?
I mean, tinfoil does keep you very fresh.
Mm-hmm. Keeps all the moisture in, so your brain doesn't dry out.
Now they'll be battling for this title. The champion of tasting terrible. It's decision time. Talk about a character assassination.
No. How the turns have tabled, but not enough.
The me versus the world mentality certainly paid off. Moving on.
Grumpy Von Grumpington versus the blonde, the slime, and the handsome.
The champion of bad attitudes. The pen is fightier. Here's the next contest. The champion of the boss level. Here we go. Scales are beginning.
Man, she's in a straitjacket, so she seems like a boss of, like, a Silent Hill game.
Yeah, but Grumpy Face Von Grumpington is impassable.
Who needs a teammate? Not this fighter.
Hmm. Ouch.
Up next.
The amazing backflipping Daredevil version the Riding Grandma.
The champion of stunts.
I mean, one of them seems to have had a better career than the other.
Actually, these are the same person, just different points
now
of time.
It's time to determine the champion of frequent ER visits. What will the trainers do? They're watching a scribble quibble. It's the Clash of the Titans.
Beaten by a coffin. Probably from Dragon.
The hilarious thing is, it turns out it's actually just the coffin. There's not a body in there or anything.
Sir tips a lot. Awesome. Lady tips a lot.
You will decide who is the champion of dating.
Oh.
Alright.
Hmm.
This is just a test of your sexual orientation.
Being afraid of commitment.
Well, according to the stereotypes.
Here come the reinforcements. It's anyone's fight.
Oh, no. That French fry man is definitely afraid of commitment. Well, so
should
is that
kept
forever,
Sir Tips-a-Lot.
Oh, this is real. This was a real close one. Cheap shot.
Not a single person in the audience was happy with that result. That was the final match. The judges
are tallying the final scores. And I don't know who won, but it was not me. Yeah, of course.
64%
Rick,
of the audience.
I need to see that Stoker finished one day. That's too good. That aesthetic, it really works.
I still think it's pretty cute. Let's see, which one, Rick? Thank you.
Stoker?
That?
Where's your complimenting me for drawing you?
You know what? You also did a great drawing of me.
Thank you! So glad that you gave an honest opinion with absolutely no scrupulous pressure whatsoever.
But I did enjoy it.
Mag. Why didn't that work?
Yeah, that was a pretty good Stoker move. I couldn't argue with that. It can't be a drama.
That was like, a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's just like champion of drama. Okay, how do I make this funniest? Oh right, I just give it the true answer.
Jackbox fishery is taking a while.
Swap your major strategy. Oh wow, he actually has a pretty good ending theme. The champion shyness.
Okay, so what do you want to play next?
Let me see. Bladder around.
I'm always into bladder around.
Okay.
I missed the last two, but I saw how good they were. Oh, man. I said, I missed out. I saw, and I couldn't believe I missed it, the Brave Little Toaster. I said, they have that in here?
Yeah, I was surprised it was in there, and also I was happy that I got people to guess it. Lego Suffers, Miller Dark, Rick Griffin, Game Cobra, me, and I didn't see who else was in here. Oh, well, I shouldn't be surprised. Being alone with my thoughts. His reflexes are kind of unearthly.
Yeah, we know how to do this. Thank gosh you already know how to
play. Onward. Like Moby Dick! I do kind of wish they'd come up with more than one example.
Yeah.
Alright, what have we got? Table prompts.
Oh, cool. I don't know one of these. Prompts are worth more, but easy prompts take
less of an emotional No. I'm gonna do three more. Oh, okay, that'll be mine. Got it.
Time is ticking. Hurry. Oh, man. Now you're going to craft a sentence that describes your prompt. On your device, you'll see two word columns. Tap all the words you want to include in your sentence, and then tap Submit when you're finished. You can always change your mind. Just tap the word again to take it out.
Okay.
Start with you.
I've got just the thing. The category is thing.
It's an old machine.
Guess what you have to do now. Guess. That means everyone in the audience, too.
Apple. We know.
In the meantime, the presenter will write another sentence.
Dishwasher.
Oh, never mind.
Oh, that... Woohoo! That was quick. Nice job.
I didn't think I'd get it that quickly. I was literally just throwing out things.
Nice! Give each other a pat on the back. And hey, give yourself a pat on the front.
Maybe after the stream.
The category is person.
Person.
They're a humongous, glorious belief human.
Time to begin.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Iden.
Oh, well then.
We must have a
start listing off gods.
I was about to do the same thing with religious figures in general. Wow, look at us.
You should seriously think about publishing.
Right, Federic.
It's a humongous hot place.
Here we go.
Sahara's horror.
Mm-hmm.
Hell. The sun.
Hell. Florida.
Heaven. Hell. Hawaii. The equator.
Desert.
Canada.
Texas.
Earthfall.
Mercury. California.
Jupiter. Venus. New Mexico.
Kalahari.
Sun.
It's smaller than Sahara.
When the presenter uses your guess in a...
Egypt.
Mojave.
So much architecture.
Beach. Middle East.
Egypt.
Death Valley. Miami.
Pyramids.
Greece. Greece.
Egypt. Rome.
It's close to Middle East.
Really?
What a fabulous sentence you've made.
Colorado.
Iran.
Iran. Iraq.
Saudi Arabia.
This place has an affluent money.
I think our audience is getting warmer.
Egypt.
Yemen. UAE.
Saudi Arabia.
Washington. Lebanon. Israel.
Whoops.
Yeah.
I don't know where to say.
Would never have thought of that.
I said UAE, and that didn't get it, and I'm like, do I need to be more specific?
Great job, everyone! And hey, here are some points for everyone who contributed a helpful guess. You're guessing a person. Ooh, tricky. It could be anyone.
They're a cranky human.
And Dracula. We're off.
The guy from House. Walter and Stardor.
I don't even know if that's how you spell their names.
They are affected by the hoarding.
Smaug.
Grinch. Bilbo. Gandalf. Thorin. Thor. They're kinda similar to Grinch.
From the Shirting Show.
Figured it out.
Oh! Dang.
By the hoarding, I don't know that.
Well, I mean, Scrooge hoards wealth.
I guess.
Yeah.
You did it! High five each other, hug the dog, smile politely at the cat.
Jeez, I didn't even think that was a Scrooge, but that was
amazing. All right, here we go.
I love people!
They're a dangerous, yummy human.
Off you go!
Dracula. Yummy mummy.
Yes.
The rubber man.
They enjoy the dining.
Yep, someone I knew this one would be guessed very quickly.
Oh, that was pretty good. Now we're talking. Let's do another 100 of these to celebrate. You're the last presenter this round. The category is person.
Almost everybody chooses person.
they're a middle-aged person figure.
Here we go.
Dracula.
Middle-aged man. Kind of. They are known for the Ego franchise.
Rick. Like Steve Jobs.
Or your wife.
How dare!
Game Cobra.
Tony Stark.
Megamind.
Walt Disney.
Gordon Ramsay.
They're kinda similar to Tony
Stark. Tony Stark.
Bruce Wayne.
Iron Man. Santa Claus. He's so talented.
A mini sentence from Matt.
Captain America. Bruce Wayne.
Batman. Tony Stark. Iron Man.
They're kinda similar to Iron Man.
Oh man.
Batman.
Edison.
And
ah.
Oh. Oh, okay.
There you go. You guys started to get on the right track, but you kept in fiction.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. They are known for the Ego franchise. Round's done. Let's take
a peek at the scores. I didn't think about I should go for the actor.
If you flipped all the ones upside down, you really wouldn't be able to tell. Round two. Your points are doubled. Yep, it's happening again. Pick a new prompt.
Let's see, what are my options?
Don't look at me.
Okay, fine. I'll pick that.
Oh, time is ticking. Hurry, hurry. Write a sentence to describe your new prompt. Did you know that you can scroll the lists up and down? You might have more words than you think.
Five seconds.
Oh. All right. Oh, it's me first. Okay.
The category is person.
They're a horrible, disgusting clone.
And so it begins. Clone man.
Dolly. Chucky.
Mega Man.
They are famous for the game Boss.
Bowser, Metroid,
the Emperor,
Liquid Snake,
Boba Fett,
Jango Fett, Solid Snake.
They're kind of similar to Bowser.
K. Rool, Ridley,
Liquid Snake,
Devil May Cry.
Hey.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Okay.
Being fancy, clever, and smart, and perfect.
Yes. Wasn't Wario only like the boss in one game? The category
is but he was famous for it.
Yes.
It's a story about a horrible, cold individual villain.
Here we go.
Scrooge again. Scrooge.
Mr. Freeze, the thing.
Jack Frost. And a dark thriller.
A Christmas story.
That snowman Christmas carrot.
It has the same vibe as Dracula. Yeti, werewolf.
Jack the Ripper.
Frankenstein.
Money.
Jack Frost.
Whoa. A fearful blade.
Oh, what a tasty sentence.
Frostmourne.
Dead and loving it.
blade. Literally blade.
Blade. Blade. Blade Runner.
It has the same vibe as Mummy.
What could this be?
Wolfman.
Excalibur.
Lincoln Vampire Hunter. From Mummy Lagoon. The Mummy.
A Nightmare on Elm Street. Friday the 13th.
Oh!
There we go.
I just started throwing them out.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's very much like Friday the 13th.
Yeah, I wasn't throwing anything out, I got stuck.
Better put on a bib, because y'all are getting success everywhere.
When you started saying mummy, I was going too far back. Yeah.
The category is person. Some of my favorite people are person.
They're a colorful, not positive person.
Let's do this.
The Grinch.
Stoker.
How dare. Botnik.
Trump. Willy Wonka.
Burgermeister Meisterburger. They are known for the villain.
That's a good one.
Joker.
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 Oh man.
They would be friends with the Joker.
Shoot.
Joker.
Pennywise.
Oh.
I'm good at this game.
Trying to think which one does color. I was gonna say Harvey Dent because white and black, but
there aren't too many people that you could say would be friends with the Joker.
Is story.
It's a story about a youthful human.
Let's get the presentation started.
Harry Potter.
The young human.
Dracula.
Who I like.
Lag.
Old Yeller. Percy Jackson.
Tom Sawyer.
Hercules.
Lord of the Flies. Huckleberry
Finn. Artemis Fowl. Peter Pan.
Don't keep us in suspense. Just buy something.
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
And a bad soul.
The Chronicles of Narnia.
Goosebumps.
Narnia.
Casper.
Soul. Coraline.
It's kinda similar to Old Yeller.
Where the Red Fern Grows.
Benji.
Damn it! Stoker, you wrote it faster than me.
A cruel gal.
I'm a
sentence.
Never seen Old Yeller eyed.
101 Dalmatians.
Madeline.
The witches.
Time is ticking. Hurry.
Isn't that what the sequel's called?
Hit the skip button to get a new sentence with all new words.
15 seconds.
Dalmatians.
You really need to be putting together more clues.
I know, but this is
why'd you
hard.
Pick this one?
There was no thing to be good choices.
Well, if you don't like your choices, you need to start skipping, because it'll let you do better stuff later on.
I know. But they didn't give me anything good.
The Devil Wears Prada. Okay, because how's that similar to Old Yeller, though?
I was trying to come up with evil ideas, because I'd at least know that much, but they weren't giving me any.
The category is story.
It's very difficult to make guesses for a movie that you haven't seen.
It's a story about a teeny person.
And so it begins.
Animorphs. Thumbelina.
The Borrowers.
Tom Thumb. The Hobbits. Edmund. The Witches.
Can't remember what the movie is called. What's the movie that Mrs. Brisby is from?
Secret of Nim.
Secret of Nim.
Hmm.
nothing. Okay.
Game Grumps. Game Grumps!
Stuart Little.
The Borrowers.
What? A teenage hottie.
All the cool words were invited to that sentence.
All the cool words were invited to that sentence.
DMNT. It's a different genre than The Hobbit.
Eight.
That was called nine.
Nine.
The hero is the class clown small town.
Star Wars.
You haven't got long left.
Calvin and Hobbes.
Power Rangers.
Cry Wolf.
Ferris Bueller. Phoebe and the Unicorn.
Denise the Menace. Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
Stoker.
Eventually, there's a not heart throb.
What?
Oh. No idea.
Okay.
Oh, Riverdale.
Wow. Okay, so.
Teeny, as in a teenager. Okay.
Yeah, that didn't help.
No, because I would have got that right away.
It's a terrible thingamajig.
Here we go again.
Steam Boy.
The U.S. government.
Dynamite. Excalibur. Nuclear bomb. Hoodwinked.
A nuke.
IBM. Godzilla.
Yeah. Gallows.
The sun.
Electric chair.
The moon.
It's nothing like nuclear bomb.
A Rubik's Cube.
Twitter.
Fine.
Yggdrasil.
Smart fine. Twitter.
Dental drill.
Facebook.
Not being computer. Able to get the waiter.
It has the same vibe as a Rubik's Cube.
Etch a sketch. Puzzle.
It does the rotation. Hellraiser.
Globe.
The lament configuration.
Rotary thing.
Lemichon's
marble box. Maze.
Hellraiser cube.
It's smaller than globe.
I absolutely adore that sentence.
Oh, go around.
Skip it.
Tangle.
Lament configuration.
Merry go round.
Get your guesses in before.
It's nothing. Jigsaw puzzle. Quite simply, it's a pocket-sized item.
Frisbee.
Ah.
Fidget spinner.
Wow. All right.
Time for the moment of
truth. Man, I got murdered this game. But the
winner is... I did all right.
Look at you.
Still in the top half. That's all I care about. That's all I can ask for.
The Hellraiser fidget spinner. With my name on it.
But things that do not need to be updated for the 21st century.
That actually went pretty quick. That was pretty good, though.
Let's play something else. In a different pack.
Someone was asking for Survive the Internet earlier.
I kind of want to do Survive the Internet again.
Yeah, Survive the Internet's really good.
Dee dee dee. We're already surviving the internet right now.
Some of us more than others.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then...
Okay, how's this going? Shoot.
We're going to survive the internet.
Mississippi voters have broken in a new flag because their old 126-year-old flag used part of the Confederate banner.
So what's the new flag look like?
It's got some red, yellow, and blue bands on it. It has like a little picture of a white lotus in the middle. I actually kind of like it.
Take a look at that. Let's see.
Sorry, I need to get in here.
They kept the words on it. Flags should never have words on them. It's just a bad idea.
Eh.
All right, are we ready to make this public? Yeah, there we go. There's the code. NZGD, New Zealand. Goddamn.
Hey, my career as a broadcast streamer is really blowing up. Don't forget you can join the audience at any time. All right, let's launch this sucker.
It's a magnolia flower, not a lotus? Okay.
Oh, that makes sense. Hi, I'm your host, Todd,
and yes, that I don't know, it's just a white flower, and so I thought it was a lotus. In case you need some instructions, check out this quick tutorial. Hey guys, what's up? Party Boy 7, here to teach you how to play
Survive the Internet. So, in each round, you'll get a prize. Frederick wants to get revenge for the pizza joke you made at his expense last time. That was an incredible burn. That was the most vicious thing I've seen in a while. Out of context. Say we're on a news site. They're super dumb would be an outrageous comment to what headline? Oh, I got it. Everybody then votes on which comment looks the most absurd. I get rewarded for writing the twist, and Paul gets some pity points for looking foolish. The person with the most points at the end of the game wins. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Please. I feel so empty inside.
Let's start things off at a social media site.
All right, what we got?
You should be seeing a prompt on your controller. There are no wrong answers, so just answer honestly.
Okay.
You're getting another player's answer on your device. Take these words out of context in the most ridiculous way you can.
All right, let's see.
here goes nothing.
Hey, I'm used to the cold. Public nudity forever. I've always wanted to try it, but never got around to it. Looks fun. Hashtag bad dragon. They always fall off to each side. Hashtag sliding ears.
Could also be sliding gears.
They invest a lot. Hashtag slasher horror icons. A fun activity for the whole family. Hashtag nude cliff diving. Ranges between neckbeard and GC. Hashtag mutton chop man.
Hey, that actually sounds close.
Like I said, I'm never allowed to be in charge. Hashtag crappy sandwiches.
Vote for the comment you think looks the worst in this context. I mean, I know who I'd vote for, but it's up to you. Let's see who got the points. And here's how the audience felt about things. Burned you. Some points for them. And you, the victim, get some pity points. You have the audience to thank for this one.
Nice.
Stoker's the sacrifice.
Let's see. I was. At the moment.
Nice.
More points than I'm used to getting in this game.
Great. Now let's go to a video site. Your second prompt is being sent to your device. Please answer it. This inspires you. Take this quote out of context so it makes its author look ridiculous. Is anyone else's heart racing right now?
Depends on if I'm hurry, but usually uncomfortable. Gangnam style parody. Hard. Frowny face. How to stop jerking off in public.
Yeah.
Looks colorful and dramatic, but it's just not for me. Sorry. Marvel movie stars children with cancer.
Man, these...
Probably so full of nerds, can't stand them. Revenge of the Nerds, all nerd scenes.
These are actually very accurate.
Father smelled of elderberries. My dad reenacting to playing Among Us. Summon an interdimensional demon by solving Rubik's Tesseract's How to Get Your Wife in the Mood.
Hell yeah.
This makes me want to stab a box multiple times. How to Hide Inside a Box. No, wait, don't put shoe polish there. My Halloween costume.
Now place your votes.
Oh no. Stoker, I'm gonna strangle ya. But I can take a good joke.
Well now, I'm doing better than usual in this game.
Let's go to a crowdfunding site.
Crowdfund. Let's see.
I'd like to answer another prompt. I'd like you to really listen to your heart this time.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Ugh. Can smell that from here. Jesus, what'd you have for dinner?
Oh, nothing unusual, just a bunch of blood.
Smells like a desiccated carcass.
Yeah, well, you know, it wasn't fresh blood, but, you know, it's still the expiration date said it was fine.
Ugh. Come on, baby. Let's do the twist.
I don't like this prompt very much, I did the best I could.
Oh, Frederick, I think I might have gotten yours.
Please help me fundraise a way to escape this political hellscape forever. I can't take it. Okay. Study English, please. Teaching children how to fight to death. I mean, it's all right, but I prefer something with more substance, feeding starving children in Africa.
You gotta teach them English!
I love the flavor, it gets in my teeth so I can savor it all day. The Red Cross for Children, Special Wish Edition. I think it tastes pretty good. Blood shakes, spice up your pre-workout drink with AV positive.
Well, there you go, Stoker, you're perfect.
Music sounds like old cheese. Fire Superstar World Tour. Please destroy these after you're done. Dim ballot collecting.
Oh, dang.
This would be easier without clothes. Help me raise $1 million.
That's good.
Okay, this is actually kind of tough.
I guess we never said this before, but are we implementing a house rule where you can't vote for yourself?
Wait, it's not, you're just not allowed to vote for yourself.
Oh, okay.
Like, your answer will not be one of your choices.
I always see it in my list of choices, I just chose not to vote for
that's the one that somebody else made of you. You can vote for that all you like.
Yeah, I had nothing for your prompt, Rick. I couldn't come up with anything. Oh, Dahan, I didn't even notice you were in here somehow.
Let's check the scoreboard.
He's caught back up in a great way.
And our last stop of the game will be at,
photo sharing, the easy one.
The points are worth double this round, so anything can happen. Okay, I hope you have one last opinion in you.
I think that might make for the funnier answers.
It's time to take the gloves off. Really go for it this time.
Seconds.
Seven.
Six. Ah, there we go, GC. Hardly contain my excitement.
Thank you all so much for everything. It's time for me to take a dive of a life.
Excuse me. Dang.
You ready for the best exhibitionist show you've ever seen?
170 likes.
Drink a hippie's blood. I'm now this high.
Drink the blood of people.
Ordered bat, banh mi, and raccoon pho, SMH 2 out of 5. Well, time to go spy on the ladies in the cabin next door. Mortadella sucks compared to this.
Oh, so savage.
Just got the ingredients, soup will be ready in a few hours.
Incredible.
Alright, the horse is falling all over the place. I want a refund.
There's a couple of these that are actually going to be difficult to choose between. No, I gotta go with, that.
Let's see how everybody voted.
Yeah, I knew that one could not be beaten.
Oh man. He was at the bottom, so. Whoa.
Oh, just edged me out at the end.
Ouch.
Congratulations.
Nice job. Very nice.
I was the ultimate sacrifice.
He took the ultimate dive.
Best burner.
Okay, we're gonna do a round of bracketeering.
Why not?
Most pity points, yeah. Yeah, I always pity GC. You always do. But I'll come back someday.
Hey, bracketeering.
Good old bracketeering. The best use of the games.
Alright, let's see. Where's that code? There it is.
Luminary.
Yeah, it's the code is... Let me enter immediately.
12.
Wait, if I say no, that means you're not allowed to answer, players, right? That's how vampires players. Work?
Yeah, totes.
We have room for three more players.
Two more players
can enter. We can get two more players in.
LMEI
is like the
two spaces for more
opposite
players.
Of LMAO.
Gotta have two more players right here.
Just one more.
One more. We can fit one more.
One
player.
More person may enter. We have the viewers.
We're actually pretty crowded tonight, too. Let's do it.
We've got like over 30 viewers. Ah, okay.
We got lurkers, is what we got.
I'm sending the topic of our first bracket to your devices now.
Most satisfying thing to type on a typewriter over and over when you're slowly losing your mind. Enter your answers now.
I mean, this seems kind of disappointing, because I have a feeling like 10 of them are just going to be all work and no play. Play along by going to jackbox.tv and entering the room code.
There we go. Hopefully, not too many people came up with an answer similar to mine.
What is that?
Because I feel like mine could have been... slightly rephrased just enough that the game wouldn't have caught it.
Hold on a second. What in the world?
All right, let's see. All right. Oh, an ad? Really? Frick. Alright, I'm gonna hedge my bets and vote for something other than mine. We got... Okay, it's just you and Federic, and Legatron and Federic. You're the only two who have not voted. And never mind, you both voted.
Voting is very important to actually getting a good score in this game. Okay,
and
so,
in life.
Fuck. No beer, no TV, make Homer go crazy. Help, and then enter, and bugger.
Bugger. Mushroom! God, I saw a post on Tumblr the other day where it was just someone posting the lyrics of Numa Numa, and like it went through multiple people adding lyrics, and the young kids on Tumblr were like, what is this Romanian song, and why does everybody know the lyrics to it? And I just
can't think of a story idea. Help. No TV, no beer, make home or something. I'm feeling fine. I knew there was gonna be that Simpsons reference.
Yeah, this is a Simpsons reference. They're trying to do not all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. They're trying to do the one level above that.
You alright there, GC?
I am a good boy, mommy says. I am a good boy. Where are the kittens, Rick? Penis, or butts.
Oh, wow.
Oh boy, this is gonna be one of those rapid clicks, isn't it?
I wonder if this actually does anything or if it's just random.
No, I think it does something.
Okay.
I don't agree with this. I just don't agree. Also, not only did my answer, which was butts, lose, but my bet, which was penis, also lost.
Never again. I like to move it. Fergal Favol and Rosebud.
Never again. It's really going back and
forth. Diego screams, no, my penis.
Oh, Remy!
I like to move it. Legric, Dodra! All right, let's see if I can win this bet. Okay, fine. Come on, Federic. Never. Time's running out. Never, excuse me.
Prediction table time is up. Let's jump back to our bracket for round two.
Alright.
Okay.
Well, I know which one I'm doing.
Just running out the clock now.
Buck, cluck, suck, muck.
Surprised this one didn't come to me.
Prediction one, everyone predicted it.
Yeah, well, of course. We're just one match away from our finals.
Hey. Ooh.
This is way closer than it should be. I don't understand. The same thing I'm looking at the same thing I'm saying looking at the election app.
Oof. Of course I lose. Oh well. And now we
what is the most satisfying thing to type on a typewriter over and over when you're slowly losing your mind?
One answer is showing some promise. Yeah, there's there's no way this one's gonna lose. I don't get the one about the kittens either, I'm gonna be real.
I think it's somebody trying to be lol random.
And yet it came so far.
Lol random is still a valid form of comedy on the internet.
That's a house pets thing. It's me. I'm just having some good laughs.
Alright.
Actually, I can't believe we got that far.
It's time for
Bracket.
We start with just the category. Enter any word ending in ing. Enter your answers now.
Alright, I'm not going for the first one that I would have normally gone for.
I feel bad about this one.
Let's see what this bracket is really about. Coolest thing to have a Guinness World Record for. Time to get
Oh,
hey everybody, look how hard I can cry.
See, I didn't choose the obvious answer. I didn't put this one down because I knew someone else would do it. What if it's both? What if it's a record and fucking sobbing?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Tie is broken. Times.
Only one person predicted that, you're kidding.
Singing, burping, streaking, puking.
Not all at the same time, please.
Guinness World Record in streaking?
From coast to coast!
Just running out the clock now.
I made it from Myanmar to Sweden without wearing a single piece of clothing.
Legda.
Let's see what tensions are mounting over in the Eastern Conference.
Explosioning, postulating, hecking, undulating.
Listen, I don't know if you know who I am, but I hold the world record in hecking.
Hey, only one of these is cool.
Explosioning, or as we call it where I come from, exploding.
Sorry. think explosioning is different from exploding, though.
You know, that's true.
Nodding, yiffing, defenestrating, inning.
Nodding.
You know what? I'm gonna go for defenestrating. That's not what I meant to click.
Before we get on to round two, it's time to make another prediction.
Oh boy. Hedging my bets again. Okay.
Forgot what defenestration, what the definition of that was, I just looked it up. Now remember, that's like the most specific word ever. That's not a technical word.
It's true. 10 seconds, Diego. Oh, never mind. Let's jump back to our bracket for round two. Oh boy, here we go.
Fucking streaking.
I mean, why do they have to fight? They can be friends.
And lose the value. Right.
My contribution has officially been eliminated.
I'm just saying, one of these subjects, the people in our group have a comic about, and the other one we don't.
No, I think that's actually not true.
Really? Who here has a comic about streaking?
Me, sort of. In a way.
To be fair, fucking could just be a swear contest.
That's true. Also, GC, you said a swear, so now you have to wash your mouth out with maple syrup.
Oh no. But hey, yeah. This kind of... Alright.
You have to get the what is it? What's the coffee? Maybe you know this, GC. What's the coffee that you can get from Tim Hortons, and it's got like 9 sugars and 9 creams? And it's named after like a famous hockey player.
It's not actually named after hockey, but I know what you're talking about. It's just basically called it's called coffee and cream. That's all it really is. Let's see.
Let's check out that scoreboard. Okay, let's see. Shabokstra. Oh, I'm in fifth. All right, what's the final frontier?
And now for the bracket you've all been waiting for, the triple blind bracket.
Yeah, this is the best bracket.
It's always the best.
Well, it's our prompt.
Spread on or sprinkle over other foods. Who knows
what
crazy twists and turns this bracket will take.
This is emotional.
Let's see what we're dealing with. Best vape flavor.
Oh boy, let's see.
Can't wait to have some of that Worcestershire vape flavor.
Mm-mm. Hello, this.
Time at the prediction table. Let's start with a bang.
Whipped cream, sprinkles, sriracha, and jizz whiz.
Whip that cream.
I mean, to be fair, whipped cream probably wouldn't taste good as smoke.
Sweet baby Elvis, we've got a winner.
Sweet baby Elvis.
Next up, rainbow jimmies, red pepper flakes, jalapeno powder, paint.
Not even sure what rainbow jimmies are.
Jimmies mean sprinkles.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
Where? Willy Wonka Land? No, I'm sorry, where did you actually say?
England.
Cream cheese, cotton relish, chocolate syrup.
Oh, sorry, New England.
Hmm.
Oh, wow. Glad you clarified. I would have been concerned it was Old England. Englished? I said Englished.
Chocolate chip would be very thick, though. Ugh.
Well, just as a vape flavor.
Yeah.
Also, I would totally do relish flavored.
Okay. I wouldn't relish the idea.
Hopes and dreams and garlic, hummus, mayonnaise, hot sauce.
It's really going back and forth. I do like the idea of hopes and dreams and garlic.
This one's looking over. It's like an Undertale branded vape flavor.
For a title change. Best replacement for the jelly in a
jelly donut. Oh, interesting.
Hmm. Okay. This actually changes things.
It does.
Rimini Ravine said, vaping with hot sauce sounds especially hazardous. Goodbye, sinuses.
Yeah, what have my sinus has ever done for me?
Time's running out. In this sense, you
I mean, you are vaping. It's not like you give too much care for them.
Time's up at the prediction table. Let's jump back to our bracket for round two.
Sriracha versus jalapeno fight. I mean, powder of any kind is not a good replacement for jelly. Just saying.
Sriracha's already got the nozzle on the top.
Yeah, see? Mmm, sriracha donuts. You know I love them. I actually don't.
Take a big bite out of the donut and powder just goes everywhere.
Oh, and it's jalapeno powder too, so
Chocolate syrup, hopes, dreams, and
that could be. It's a bracket like this that makes this game the sport of kings.
Hmm. Hopes and dreams and garlic.
I feel like the chocolate syrup would just be asking for a mess.
You will not be denied. That's probably been done before, that somebody put chocolate inside of a jelly donut?
Oh, probably.
I could totally see a chocolate syrup being a donut, though. Ooh, that actually sounds good. Man, I like how simple the answer is, and Yeah.
I mean, do you actually want to hurt someone? Because the sriracha would do it.
I'm saying chocolate syrup, because chocolate syrup is used in fake blood. So you just shoot a bunch of blood out of a cannon.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, but I can eat that ammunition.
Wow. My poor sriracha. It came so far. But in the end, it didn't even matter.
But who walked away with the top score?
I might make it into the top 5.
Drebuck's leg.
Oh, well, I made it into the top 10.
In like 4th place for this entire time.
8.
I did adequately by guessing correctly on every voting round, but it wasn't enough.
It was satisfying for me to type on a typer. Oh, I have a better answer now.
Okay. I think we're done for tonight.
Yeah,
I think so too.
I had a call too. It was fun.
Good night.
Good old Jackbox. Good old Jackbox here to give us all good laughs tonight.
Thank you everybody for stopping by and participating in nonsense.
Yes, thank you for the enjoyable distraction from all the doom scrolling. Everyone try not to stress
a
too much.
A little nonsense and now and then is relished by the wisest men.
If it makes you feel better, I got a good whooping tonight, but I appreciate it. I hope you have a good night.
Yes, good night, everybody.
I'm not even worried at all. President doesn't get voted in tonight. That doesn't happen until December 13th.
Hey, you keep pounding up this channel.
Good night.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.